Hello and welcome to Snettertons Farm. We're here down actually at the store, and we're going to do a couple of purchases, and then we're going to transport the stuff back to the farm. So we're down here with our Land Rover. We need to do a couple of little purchases, and I say take them back up to the farm. So we need a couple of things. First off, we need, let's see, where is it? So we need a wheel loader. Don't really have a huge set of options, really. We're just going to grab the JCB. Standard wheel setup would be fine. And we'll get a shovel. Again, standard shovel. We don't really have much other option. I don't think could be used. No. Not sure it can be used for manure, but want to use it for manure, and I don't. Do I think it can actually be used for manure? Silage fork. We'll stick to the shovel for the moment. Right, that was one of the things we needed. What was the other thing? Oh yes. Wasn't a truck. So what I wanted to do was grab. I wanted to grab a nice forage harvester. We've got some corn coming up, and I wanted to do wanted to get that with the forage harvester. Now I'm trying to think which one I want to get. This one has an integral cargo. Element to it. I want to test. I haven't actually tried it out, so I'm kind of reluctant to test it and see how big it is. What I'm actually thinking is this guy here, and gonna need two headers for him, but. Essentially, one of them is going to be actually so one essentially is going to be used on the corn. A nice wide one actually. 6 meters. We also want this one, which is a grass beastie. I'm gonna take that. I think that will fit. I hope actually that will fit. I'm also going to take one of those as well. We should have trailer. I can't remember where it is. Maybe it's in the misc. Miscellaneous. I maybe didn't actually put it on the server, on the install it. Okay, we'll save that. We'll pick that up later. We'll bring the low loader down. Okay, so let's get all of these things hooked up. So we need, the wheel loader. All of this stuff needs to go up to the farmyard. So let's get this attached, and so I'll move this over here for the moment. Well, essentially just do a little convoy with follow me, so things will basically just quite naturally go together. Now, the reason why I wanted this grass one, I'm actually going to actually that does actually go on there, that's fine. Although it doesn't actually fit, strangely enough. Okay, we won't actually be using this one. Because it actually doesn't fit. It has a awkward. Position on there. Seems actually there's actually okay. That, however, works fine. So basically, the idea is this guy is just going to be used to pick up. Well, is this grass pickup or is this actually? Oh, I have a sneaky feeling this is grass pickup. It won't cut. Maybe it will cut. We're going to test it anyway. And maybe end up selling both these attachments. Well, we'll give me some one definitely. But it essentially won't work. I'm not sure how what we can do. What we could actually do. So this actually, I think there is. So I do have this forage harvester, which I think is the one it's supposed to go with. Annoyingly, it's a mod where the pricing of it is a little bit off. Essentially, I might end up switching out the forage harvesters. It doesn't really make any difference. I do like the camo on it, but it's kind of a little bit no, that actually fits. Right, we're going to use the what do you call it first, the actual wheel loader, because that's probably the slowest of all these. The Land Rover is definitely the quickest. That can go at the back. So let's get this up to farm. We may end up selling one of these. I have a sneaky feeling we might end up selling this one and the attachment, just because we've got potential
issue that they won't necessarily work. I'm going to try and get everybody into this area here before that car comes. Right, everyone is on the road, so let's go. So we have a couple of things sort of set up. It's say 11 a.m. on the game. Oops. Ooh, that is not good. Hopefully nothing else will hit it. I really don't want anything to... It all sort of skidded to a halt. Oh, I do like it when they do that. That's actually kind of gets around the whole issue of the traffic, because you get this have the problem of traffic, and things get stuck. And how do you deal with that? Everything is kind of held up. The Land Rover at the back is actually the quickest of all these vehicles, but I mean, I've got the pedal to the metal, as it were. A Land Rover's like at the back trying to go. Not having an issue. So my idea with the grass attachment, I'm hoping it's a cutter, is I'm wanting something that I can use on field one that can mow and not be too big and not suffer from the issues we've had with field 10 with the other mower. We need this to sort of deal with right, we do have traffic, so I'm kind of what I'm nervous about making this turn, because I don't want anything to get stuck. Of course. How about that for absolute precision? So I actually have a course play worker doing field 6 and spraying it at the moment. If that's finished in the time we have, I will move him on to field 20, I think. Or actually maybe field 7. Just want to get everything and everyone fertilised, because we're not doing the 3-step with chopped straw. We have to spray, and might get a bigger sprayer as a result, because that small sprayer is actually, you know, it's quite small, 14 metre. It works, but it is, yeah, it does the job, to be honest. It works. So we're going to need this to do the manure. So this is going to be deposited at the pigs, I think. I think that has the most manure at the moment. Something made it around, yep. I think we're going to have a very busy harvest season. We have so much to do. Hopefully they'll get through that without crashing. be data. Oh no. I don't know how that managed to basically mess that up. Completely skidded out. No idea where that Land Rover's going. I really don't know. I have no idea where he has just gone to. Really don't. That is insane. Drop this guy here for the moment. We'll decide which one of these two things we're going to use in a little while. Effectively, we've got to sort of test to see if this actually does work with grass. We'll do it on a little stretch here. What we'll actually do, so it doesn't matter. That is unfortunate. No, it doesn't matter. It doesn't cut. And when I chose this mod, it was supposed to cut, and it doesn't. So I'm actually going to ditch it because it doesn't do what I need it to do. I need something that can cut grass. I might just keep this around for a minute, for a little while. For the moment, I won't get rid of it. But I'm going to get rid of that. It's unfortunate. It doesn't quite do what I wanted it to do. So, let's get into this puppy. Let's take this to the pigs. We do have a manure wagon already at the pigs, and we do need to sort of get that done and filled up. We're not using the milling machine that we use at Cherry Hills, and I'm inclined not to use that one. I might use the Pottinger one that I've got at some point, but I think for the moment, because we don't have a huge amount, let's use this. It's kind of it will do the job.
So. It's full. Oh, there was actually more than this here. There was literally, I thought there was close to 17k. Full yet. I literally just want to get the last bit. Make it all. Okay. This into the there we go. Puzzles me why there's actually a car parked here, but anyway. Okay, let's just kind of leave that there. That is, we'll fill this up slowly. We'll get that full, but theoretically we could use that right now with a helper, and it will actually keep it filled. Let's check the cows and see how much we've got on the cows. Maybe it's the cows that's got more. It's the cows that's got more. So actually what might be worth doing is heading over to the cows with this. And we could, actually no, let's not, let's leave that for the moment. We'll leave that there. Okay, so let's just quickly check on the map, see how things are going. So he's nearly finished. Let's head back to the Land Rover. This field here is the field I want to cut. And I want to kind of cut it in a sensible way, and the mower that we used earlier for this field, it doesn't quite do it properly. The mower here is going to have problems with the size of this field, so that's one of the reasons why I'm looking for an alternative way to cut. So if I can use a forage harvester, something like this, these headers, or something like this, is actually what we've just done, then it would be useful, but they're pickup only and these don't cut, well, they don't cut grass anyway. Oh, actually that one does. Oh my goodness me, the crone one does. We're going to reset this to the yard because we don't have anything down here. But if that does actually do what I think it does, then that's going to be awesome. Let's head back to the farmyard. Let's run. Let's run across all the grass. Very beautiful, by the way, is Snettertons Farm. If you just look at this, this is our little lake. Our pond, whatever,
by the house. It's absolutely really beautiful. Really well done. Is this map? Okay, where did I pop it? I think it is this one. So, let's. Somewhere. Oh, there it is. So, this should now be able to cut. Because that definitely is a cutter. So, this is field one. The awkwardness about field one is literally it's again, it's another one that's got a really tight size. Kind of have this arrangement with this one. We should be able to just hire a worker. Okay. Well, let's essentially a combine. If we go here, this is field one, we're in the southeast corner, and we're going to go west. Actually, we need need that. We do drive course. Hopefully, he will start. Now, it's doing this usual. You've got to be a good distance away from the start point, or else you end up doing the circles. And the circles are fun. Not really. Now, what I need is actually working. Why he's going through the middle of the field. Oh. Because he's gone there. Okay. That slipping that we saw there, that is literally the terrain stuff. It can make these things just slip. And of course, that's better. Okay, so what we... Okay, he's going. So he's driving the course. What we need grab one. I'm trying to remember where it is. We have forage wagon somewhere. There we are. Okay, so I don't need Windrow. I should have probably dropped it somewhere else. Let's basically, because I need to get out of here, of course, and I have literally put the Windrow in the way. Let's just put the Windrow in a shed at the top. Essentially, we'll drive through. So that guy's cutting, which is great. And what I can do is, this is our nice class tractor. Kind of cuts, he's cutting the headland, which is good. Which is basically where this guy's going to sit. In theory, what might happen now is gonna come past, hopefully not too close. Actually, load a ton as he comes past, actually. We're gonna kind of leave that to it actually. He's cutting away and effectively we are pretty sorted here. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna leave the trailer there for a minute. The reason for that is I'm gonna set up a course play. But with that, I'm going to sort of leave you guys here, and we'll see you guys next time. If you've enjoyed today's episode, I'm sorry it's been a bit not action-packed. We've done a few things, but we've not done a huge amount, strangely enough. It's a little bit of chores, and it's a really hard part of the seasons, because we can't do any planting, we can't do any harvesting. We've got two essentially game days as part of summer where we can't really do much, and I'm doing grass to try and basically get something done. But as I say, it's not a hugely exciting episode, I'm afraid to say. So if you've liked the episode, please hit the like button. If you want to see more from the series and our Cherry Hill series, please hit the subscribe button. And with that, thank you all for watching. Have a great day and see you guys next time. Goodbye.